Hello there and welcome back to this video series on programming for problem solving using C language. After watching this video, you'll be able to explain the link between pointers and arrays. It would be highly beneficial if you watch videos 35 to 39 once again before you go further into this video. Let us recap a little bit about what we mean by a pointer. A pointer is a variable that holds the address of another variable. That is, int pointers can hold addresses of int variables. Int pointers can hold addresses of characters and so on. An int pointer is declared as int star px, that is integer pointer variable px. Here the star is read as pointer. We'll just look at one more fact about pointers and then go into the next recap. Okay. Unary operator star is read as value at when you are initializing or assigning or accessing. When you say int p, it declares an integer variable p. When you say int star px, it will declare a pointer variable px. And when you say is equal to end p, it will initialize its value as address of p. So now px will contain address of p. Okay. This we need to remember very carefully. This last statement must be understood as the address of p is this, is assigned to the integer pointer px. Okay. We will see a little bit more about these when we look into arrays, pointers and functions later. We'll recap about array further. Array variable can hold several values of the same type. I didn't mention same type here because we mentioned over and over again. Okay. For example, if you say int age 4, 4 is the capacity and int is the type. So this age is a array variable that can hold four values, a subscript 0, a1, a2 and a3, that are held in square brackets. Now we'll try to see the link between pointers and arrays. Perhaps you need to pay close attention here. When we declare int age 4, okay, four contiguous memory locations are stored as shown over here. Age 0, age 1, age 2 and age 3. The fun really begins here because the name of the variable age is a pointer to the first location, which can also be read as age plus 0. Age plus 1 points to the next element, age plus 2 points to the next element, age plus 3 points to the next element, and star age plus 0 is equal to 78 sets the value of this as 78. Star age plus 1 is equal to 39 sets it as 39 and so on. Okay, but if you can further look at these addresses, of course these numbers may be different on your machine, but this is 0, 4, 8 and 12. Now when we say age within square brackets I, that is same as star age plus I. Okay, this star age plus I is the same as star I plus A, because A plus B is equal to B plus A, and so this is I within square brackets age. So whether you write age within square brackets I or I within square brackets age, internally both are the same, because the moment you say age within square brackets I, C compiler internally converts it to star age plus I. Okay, carefully watch this, rewind and watch this, watch each and every what is this star operator mean. Star age plus 0 is value at address age plus 0 is assigned a value of 78. Value at address age plus 1 is assigned a value of 39 and so on. This needs to be very carefully seen. So in summary, we will say that array elements can be accessed as age within square brackets I, or I within square brackets age, or star age plus I. Age plus I is the address of age I. If you put a star in front of it, it will get the value, right? So to familiarize yourself, read the program in the next page very carefully and then run it to convince yourself that you got it right. The name of this file is addresses.c. If you want this file, you can ask me and I will email that to you. I think that's all for now. Have a great day.